On the Ides of March, or March 15th, a great Roman man called Julius Caesar was assassinated when he was stabbed an estimated 23 times. Many more influential people around the world would meet a similar fate in the years to come. Those who fell to the hand of an assassin or assassins include the great Mahatma Gandhi, John F. Kennedy, and the man suspected of killing him, Lee Harvey Oswald. Then you have the assassination of the Archduke Franz Ferdinand, something blamed for kicking off World War I. President Abraham Lincoln took a bullet to the head, while Martin Luther King Jr. was also assassinated the American way, killed with a firearm. Today we're going to introduce you to someone you might not have heard about, but you should have. His story is fascinating and his death is intriguing. This man, known as Ramesses III, was the second pharaoh of the 20th dynasty in Egypt, and his reign lasted from 1186 to 1155 BC. That's a long time ago, but if you want to see what this guy vaguely looked like, you can, because you can search for images of his mummy online. And you know what people are saying about those remains these days? That it looks like old Ramesses had his throat slit. But let's rewind just a little bit. From what we know about the man, he was a good if not great leader. During his time as pharaoh, what's known as the New Kingdom or Egyptian Empire was coming to an end. As empires always tend to do, it was heading toward decline. After he was gone, the trouble really started. But while he was in charge, he was successful, having beat back Libyan armies twice and making short shrift of the Sea Peoples. These people didn't get into Egypt, but they would attack again. It's said, in all, our hero today and his armies fought them off three times. As one historian points out, these fights were big deals. He writes, "It should be stressed that the invasions were not merely military operations, but involved the movements of large populations, by land and sea, seeking new lands to settle." Let's just say Ramesses, having won a trio of invasions, likely won over a lot of people. How do we even know what went down more than 3,000 years ago? We don't really, not exactly. But historians rely on what the inscriptions say at Ramesses III's Medinet Habu mortuary temple. You can also hear this in something called the Harris Papyrus. "As for those who reached my frontier, their seed is not. Their heart and their soul are finished forever and ever. As for those who came forward together on the seas, the full flame was in front of them at the Nile's mouths, while a stockade of lances surrounded them on the shore, prostrated them on the beach, slain and made into heaps from head to tail." Yeah, he messed them up. Okay, so he won battles. But when empires go into decline, it always starts with a lot of infighting, usually peppered with decadence and many bad decisions. We also have to take into account that some of the people he defeated were settled nearby, and this might have led to new states being formed that would lead to the empire's downfall. Egypt had been fighting on land and in the sea, and as you know, especially if you check out our cost of defense shows, constantly being a warlike nation or defending yourself means spending tons of cash. No empire in the past has ever survived overspending when fighting on too many fronts. This economic turmoil took its toll on the normal people, and they had to put up with the ancient form of austerity, which basically meant less grain. When the people suffer, when it looks like there's no way out, usually a bunch of other powerful people get together and start machinating about how to get rid of the failing leader. This is where our conspiracy comes in. We're told that for a long time, no one really knew how exactly Ramesses had been assassinated. Papyrus court documents were found that indeed tell us that a coup had been planned. This is known as the Harem Conspiracy, because the key figures behind the murder were said to be one of Ramesses' second wives and her co-conspirators, because she wanted to put her son, Pentawer, in charge. This is how the tale goes. It was just a normal night in Ramesses' harem, but little did he know that one of his many wives were planning to take him out, as well as his son Ramesses IV, and give power to her child. She had before this enlisted various officials, who it said were in on the plan, doubtless worried by the state of the empire. She needed a lot of help though, and even got kitchen staff and other servants in on the action. It's said the most important ally in this assassination was a pantry chef called Pabekaman. You see, not just anyone could walk right into the harem. To get in, Pabekaman had to enlist a few helpers himself, and it was all looking rather like an ancient Egyptian version of Ocean's 11. But given the time, the conspirators also employed those who were able to use black magic to weaken both the pharaoh and the guards around him. It's said that while the actual assassination was in play, someone was casting spells and performing incantations. We cannot verify if this part of the killing process worked, but with modern science, we're sure skeptical. It seems the attack was successful, but there's always been a shade of mystery as to how he actually died. We'll get around to that, but we can say the assassination did work. We might also add that Ramesses IV was not felt, and this spelled trouble for the gang of murderous usurpers. In a document called the Judicial Papyrus of Turin, it's written that people were put on trial, and names were revealed. It's also said a number of officials in on the plot had been blackmailed, but that didn't save all of them. That document reads that in all, 27 men and 6 women were convicted of high treason, and another 5 of corruption. It also reads that most of them should be killed, with the document saying that the court was not killing them, but their actions had killed them. It's not known exactly how they were put to death, but we're told that a number of them took their own lives. 3 of them got off lightly too, and they were merely disfigured. Another got an ancient slap on the wrist. The son who would be king, Pentuer, may have killed himself. No one knows for sure, but some documents seem to infer that he was forced to take his own life. The empire was a mess. The pharaoh had been slaughtered. The other main players had either been killed or were perhaps worried about the state things were in. This was the beginning of the great descent that led toward the end of the empire. But how did Ramesses die? Did he actually have his throat slit? Life Science tells us that researchers had for a long time been mulling over the actual cause of death, with some people saying he was stabbed, slashed, and he died immediately, but other people saying he was hurt but lasted another 3 days. So scientists got a hold of the mummy, but this time they were armed with a computed tomography machine, and they performed what are known as CT scans. The large and deep cut wound in his neck must have been caused by a sharp knife or other blade, said the scientists. They added that it was quite the deep wound, and whoever got Ramesses' neck had severed his large blood vessels as well as his trachea and esophagus. Their conclusion was that there was no way in hell that the great pharaoh did much after this, as such a vicious cut would have killed him almost instantly. That also had another surprise. They found an amulet buried in his throat. This had been buried by bandages, and no one had ever seen it before. Most probably, the ancient Egyptian embalmers tried to restore the wound during mummification by inserting the amulet and by covering the neck with a collar of thick linen layers, wrote the researchers. The amulet, no doubt, was to give him some good luck as he passed into the underworld. But they went even further and went to inspect a mummy they believed was Pentuer. This mummy was known as Unknown Man E. So did he really kill himself? They don't really know, but they did say genetic analysis made them feel pretty sure that they'd got their mummy. It was the son, and all they could say about his death is that his utterly horrific, contorted expression likely means he died horribly. They said he might not have actually killed himself, stating he may have been poisoned or even buried alive. Pentuer didn't get an amulet either. He got a goat skin. In ancient Egypt, this was regarded as a really dirty, impure thing. So in modern times, it was like he got buried with a mangy old sock or a used toothbrush. They likely wanted him to suffer as much as possible during his eternal journey to the underworld. This all sounds a bit grim, but you just have to look at the photo of this mummy going through the CT scan machine. Talk about old world meets the modern world. It's thought that the great leader was around 62 years old when he died, which is quite the run for someone in those days. What's perhaps more amazing is Ramesses II, who reigned for 62 years, lived until the ripe old age of either 91 or 92. That's the end of this ancient tale. What do you think? Do you know anything you can add to this show? Tell us in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video, Thief Who Hijacked a Plane and Stole $1 Million. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. We'll see you next time.